the driver to breathe into or spare mouthpieces, because every time you have to administer a breath test for the driver, you have to replace the mouthpiece, right? You can't go around blowing into this and then have somebody else blow into it.
But
I mean, that's how HIV spreads.
But for the, in the interest of saving money, what you can actually do is you don't use them all. You don't repeat using them in one night. But what you can do is you can actually sanitize them afterwards.
You can.
There's nothing wrong with sanitizing them later on.
You got to
clean
them
out properly.
All right. Sorry about that joke. I wasn't serious about HIV spreading through a breath test. So of course not. But you do have to be a little bit more hygienic when you test one of these things. All right. So are we ready? Because we've got two of our test subjects, if we can call them that, although I think they're really enjoying themselves, who are going to be tested now with one of these breath testing kits that Yves brought with him. Let's call in our resident hardball sportscaster, Voyet Season, who's busy sucking a straw and not blowing into a straw. All right, Voyet, join us here. Yves, can you switch this on? I mean, how do you switch this
on? Which one do you want?
All right.
Do I have a choice?
Yeah, I have a choice.
You
know.
Okay. All right. Switch it on. I'm going to turn it on. I'm going to tell you where, about 24 degrees.
The temperature
is the
right
temperature outside.
The ambient temperature. Yeah. All right. Now, Yves, how does he do it now?
And then blow. Straight out. Until you hear a tick. Tick.
Okay. Now, we'll take the reading.
Point. 30. 0.30. You've been drinking.
0.30.
You've been drinking rubbing alcohol.
I have to do this for the show.
I know the sacrifices of Boyd Tito has to make.
Yeah,
and of course, we're joined here by my executive producer, Dino Ponti Orig, who obviously prefers to miss his volleyball game tonight so that he can participate in this science experiment. All right, ready? All right, there you go. You hear the tick, and
there really is a tick.
There's a tick in every one of us.
Point one. So.
Point one.
I think this one registers it not in point zero. So basically, the two of them would still pass. I mean, if we were talking about point six.
Yeah.
So
point zero six.
But I think it's just. Because I don't think they're 0.1. I don't think he's 0.3 yet, because he's only had two drinks.
All right. Although I think the scientific explanation for that as well is that alcohol absorption into the body differs with body mass. So obviously, if you compare Boyas with Mr. Muscles here.
No, but that's the thing. I don't think he has 0.3 in his blood, because that would... That might kill him already. That's
too toxic.
Maybe the decimal.
Oh, but you don't know what can kill other people won't kill Boyas.
You guys been drinking for a while?
No. I'm just saying he has just a higher tolerance for deadly stuff. Thank you, gentlemen. Please back to the bar. Back to the bar exams you go. All right. Well, thanks very much, Yves. That's a nifty. Way of demonstrating to the people exactly what might be in store for them if and when Congress and the Senate do agree on a law that will set the legal limit for blood alcohol. So are you going to purchase more of these things? Is MMDA going to purchase more? I mean, that's $68,000 a pop.
Well, for sure, if we have a law already that would allow us to actually use these things, we'd purchase more, because we need to deploy them in a lot of different areas, because especially now that the Christmas season is coming up, there's going to be a lot of people drinking and driving. So, and hopefully, if we get them in, let's say, 50 pieces, 100 pieces, they might be cheaper.
They might be cheaper.
Yeah.
And would that require bidding?
I think for the Philippines, the thing is, there's only one exclusive supplier of this one. But if it will require a bidding, of course, we'll bid it out.
All right, you'll bid it out. And maybe just as a suggestion, even though there's still no law yet, but maybe you can go out and do some testing during the Christmas season, just to position some people near the roads going to bars or, you know, drinking establishments, and maybe just pick out some random subjects for testing. How's that idea?
You could take that under consideration, but of course, we don't want to inconvenience the public, especially if, you know, it's a Christmas season.
Yeah, position the MMDA outside EBS. Go ahead. Just kidding. Yves Gonzalez, thanks very much for coming.
No problem.
We can follow you at Twitter.
Yes, follow MMDA Twitter, twitter.com/MMDA.
Uh-huh. And you have a personal Twitter account also.
Twitter.com/WZ.
And why is it double Zeta?
Two Z's in the Gonzalez.
Yeah, not a Z with an S. All right. Thank you very much, Yves Gonzalez from the MMDA. Hope to see those devices in use pretty soon. And coming up ahead, we go big and small with brewers of the country's most popular alcoholic drink when Future Perfect returns.